Evan, Kip, welcome to, about time to welcome to the Common Thread Collective, because I think we have that common thread. That common thread we can say historically. We can say in terms of soul to soul, the word soul. So tell us a bit, what is soul as an acronym for what?
Summer of Unconditional Love.
Well, what do you mean by, how do you define unconditional love? We like one another, we connect to one another, we find this message. Val mentioned the 50th anniversary of the human being. In fact, I was there, I didn't have a prayer to open it up. And then at this academic conference, I was there briefly, but asked to leave because I didn't have the proper badge, although I was the one person I looked around.
In 86, by soul.
Who was there.
You're welcome, Dan.
Who was there 85, I was there 50 years ago, and a lot of there were going to have kind of academic comment about LSD, about how the Black Panthers, and we're going to be talking to Robin, who's working with the Black Panthers and the hippie movement, where it met, because I was in the midst of that, being a father in a mixed family in the Fillmore at the time. And politically out of which came in another, my other radio, where my beginning, KPOO 89.5 on the now in Divisadero, but then it was on the Toma Street, and I worked on having it become the voice of all that, because they saw we needed a voice. And again, so Cap Evan, tell us a bit about what you're about, and what this 50 years ago, you're on this path. Tell us about the path you're on and how we can do more together.
Frankly, it all started with Bernie Sanders' presidential campaign. That was our awakening call to action. We had some lofty ideas we wanted to do to get involved with Bernie. We were campaigning for him. I started a online campaign on Facebook called Bernie Loves Us. We grew to about 14,000 followers, which is fun. They still post articles on there every couple days. Put some up just to keep people engaged. Bernie's still alive and well, doing stuff in the Senate, obviously, and all that. I, however, and have dragged Kip along with me, as far from politics as we can get. We're going the other end of the spectrum. We're going for unconditional love. Pretty much the opposite of politics, I think.
Nice.
And we recognized as Bernie's campaign was falling apart there around June, we're headed for that brick wall of the DNC in July when it was all over for him. And we saw that coming, and we wanted to attach ourselves to something that was a little farther down the road in the offing, and we just realized that it was the 50th anniversary of the Summer of Love the next year, now this year, and we said we're going to attach ourselves to that, and we're going to help make this a beacon for the world to see why it matters that counterculture started in the Haight-Ashbury district of San Francisco in the late 60s, culminating in this eponymous Summer of Love that has ripple effects through our culture far and wide and around the world today. And we're just so happy to be a part of this and help fueling the action and participating in it and sponsoring events and performing at events. We played the Global Love Day celebration at Sunday Streets in the Tenderloin. We opened the Haight Street Fair Summer of Love stage. And we were invited to participate with the Magic Bus, our friend's tour group with Antenna Theater, the Magic Bus, in the Pride Parade. We were invited by Pride to come participate. Diamond Dave marched with us in the Pride Parade to represent Summer of Love and the 50th anniversary of the Beatles song, All You Need Is Love. We were blaring, All You Need Is Love, the whole way down Market Street. We hired an airplane to do Skywritten Hearts in the Sky. That was us.
Wow, I saw those hearts in the sky. Wasn't in the city that day. I was over on Angel Island and I saw the hearts in the sky.
Didn't need to be. Actually, he was out by you on the airplane. So it was a super, it's just been an amazing, amazing year. And so much of this kicked off at the 50th anniversary of the Human Being at Gray Area Theater on Mission. And that's where we started to get introduced and better acquainted with a lot of the people we've been interacting with all year long. And it's on, and it's still on full force. We've been going to as many of the exhibitions as we can and events. We've been interviewing curators from all the museums and the executive directors, all as many of those as possible. We're putting on our YouTube channel, Now Share Love, one word. On our website, nowsharelove.org. We share as much as we can on Facebook, all the social media, all that stuff. We are soul. Summer of Unconditional Love. Kip and I are the soul twins. When we play music, it's soul twin messiah. This is just, we've been brought together to spread this love message. And I'll let Kip tell you a little about the love message, because he is our spiritual guru.
Spiritual guru, Kip.
Well, and to back up just a little bit how we met, and like Evan said, I've been on the love trip, so to speak, for about 8 years now. I'm a film television producer, amongst other things. Moved to the Bay Area in 85. I've always made the joke I was looking for the 60s, 20 years too late. Little did I know I was 30 years too early.
And still here.
Infinity's always sort of been my point of seeking, and it was about 8 years ago that point, infinite point of seeking, collided with love. I walked into this filmmaking event, and there was about 100 people in there, and I realized I was in love with everyone in the room. And I realized that's not only how we can feel about everyone and everything, but it's really how we should. Why wouldn't we want to? Why wouldn't you want to walk around every moment of your life feeling like you're in love with everything?
Fellow human beings. I say fellow human beings, yeah. Doing more together than any of us can do on our own.
And all life, man, all life. And so...
Let's do it.
So about...
Now we're doing it.
So, Evan was going to the Academy of Art, and a friend of mine, Kern Engel, was one of his instructors, and he reached out to... Bernie said, hey, I want to, you know, do this thing with Bernie. I want to tell him a love story, because he's actually got a book called The Secret Power of Love that he's been working on. And Curran said, you know, Evan said, hey, who should I work with? And Curran said, why, Kip Baldwin.
Period.
And that was it. And since then, and just to take a moment to honor Curran, he passed away a couple months after connecting Evan and I from cancer. And he's just a beautiful, beautiful soul. How, like Evan described, you know, we both realize that fighting against what is only props it up. There's a lot of solutions. There's literally millions of people in the world with tons of great ideas and resources all focused on love. Let's focus on the solutions, not the problems. And so we started saying, okay, well, let's create a place for people to come to. And we, oh, Summer of Unconditional Love, we're in San Francisco, let's honor the original Summer of Love. We didn't know, like Evan said, it was the 50th anniversary of the Summer of Love. And then when we came up with this, I'd worked with the Hirsch Corporation, oddly enough, doing a grass-fed beef pet food. My friend is a Hirsch family archivist, and he sat on the board of the California Historical Society, who introduced us to the man of a million phone calls, Adam Hirschfelder, who is the director of
Strategic Initiatives
at California Historical Society. And from that, we've been introduced to everybody. We've been in the heart of everything. So we're telling this story from the inside out, not the outside in. And what we're focusing on, even at this counterculture conference, what we saw was they're still sort of focusing, did the counterculture succeed, did it fail, were the hippies a lost cause, basically. No, we won. We won all the culture wars, as Peter Coyote says. We may have lost all the political ones because we're trying to fit the square peg of love into the round hole of fear, and that's not going to work, I don't believe. And but you look at just, say, the transgender issue in the military. Were we even having a conversation about transgenders 50 years ago? Where's cannabis at 50 years ago? Illegal. Now it's legal. On and on and on. Women's rights, yeah, maybe we've got a long way to go on all these issues, but we're light years ahead.
We had a viable presidential candidate who was a female. That's come a ways.
Well, working on it together, that's certainly the theme of the show, eh, Val?
Absolutely.
Putting it out there on the planet,
yep.
Finding that common thread, and the common thread is doing more together than any of us could do our own. And I think we're at a time, I'm kind of at a time where it looks like the darkest, I'm talking about Trump, is not going to last that long. And there's now I keep up with it, the knowledge grandeur being formed. It seems very likely that all of the stuff he did is going to come out. He's going to go from the White House to the jailhouse. I believe I've said it on the show some months ago, maybe over a year ago. So let us emerge as fellow human beings on the planet. That's what I see, basically. And that's where they're doing more together, fellow human beings on the planet. Whatever these borders, these divisions, and so on, these genders, that's why I say transgendering all past categories. We welcome all cool folk. You know you are out here in the cutting edge. And that's where we are here on Mutiny Radio, here at the Common Thread Collective. And I see you have a guitar. I believe I have a song that will connect totally and completely to what we're about. Take it away, brother. Okay. There we go.
Oh,
love's all about.
Paul.
Yeah.
My goodness. This guy came crashing down.
Kim Baldwin.
Most ready now.
And you guys.
Awesome.
Awesome is right.
Summer of unconditional love is here.
And we I say the past shakes hands with the future, the now. Right now. I say often you've heard me, but now say dancing sideways down the ribbon of time, the path ahead lit by the echo behind. And you definitely bring this echo behind, so welcome to the Common Thread Collective. I think there's a lot of good work. If you can say a good work, we say that you can have good work and be having fun too, and I think that's part of the unconditional wet love. And we put it around the planet every week, and you're welcome to be part of it. And I'm soon to be, as the old timer here, I'm coming on my 80th birthday.
Whoa!
I'm 80 years old. And so I want to invite you, hey Val, thinking now we're November 3rd, 12th or 13th will be at Adobe Bookstore. I want to invite you two to be part of it. And also we'll have these two in Trio Cambio will feature as well.
Bring it.
And you know Trio Cambio?
Not familiar.
Three women. We're putting forth this very same little mile out of the mission. That's Wind Song and Company. They put a political and the best edge to it of politics and people coming together. And you five will be featured, plus whoever else shows up, at Adobe Bookstore November 12th and 13th, my 80th birthday.
We are so incredibly honored, Dave. Thank
well,
you so
we
much.
Well, we're honored also between now and then. I want you to be well to bring people by. I think what we're getting with the Summer of Unconditional Love, I was saying when I was walking, what is that? What we're bringing is, we might as well go for it. Might as well go for it and have this unique role. And with Val and I being able to bring in people around the planet, the spirit.
And Dave, you know, one thing I wanted to say about Trump, and this will sound strange, Ev and I love Donald Trump, and I'll tell you why. Because he's given us a clear choice. You know, it's like this is the universe saying, do you want to go forward or do you want to go backwards? Every time he said, let's make America great again for who, when?
White people.
Yeah, old white
guys.
Men.
White guys, well, he's...
No offense, Dave.
And it's still great for them.
Or to myself for that.
I mean us.
It doesn't work for anybody. As Dave is kind of fond of saying and has inspired some of my poetry, it's always darkest right before the dawn, right? And I think we've seen how deep and dark mankind has gone. Yeah. So the only conclusion that must be drawn is it is time for a renaissance. And so this is the shift that we, you know, aim to make here on the show every week by giving people a platform for expression, celebrating rights and free speech, and promoting love and community and togetherness, and making that energy shift that needs to happen, because there's so much of that darkness that's just kind of like hanging out kind of as a smokescreen in front of everybody right now.
Well, I get inspired by how powerful it is. It's so powerful, you have to figure the countervailing forces that respond to it are going to be a tsunami wave of love, of opposition to greed,
coming
and
together,
et cetera.
Fighting one another, you know, and fighting each other. I was at
opposition to the fact that there is a 1%, not the 1%, not those human beings who are just trying their best to succeed as they were taught and programmed to do, but that we love across the board. We do it for them and for us and for us all.
Well, welcome, brother. Welcome, brothers. Today is the first day of the rest of our life. There was a beat poet who said that, Ginsburg, Judge Gregory Corso, who said today is the first day of the rest of your life. And here we are. And as I was thinking, putting this out around the planet. I was at the Rainbow Gathering every year. The Rainbow Gathering. I think you've heard of it.
Oh yes, we have.
I don't know if you've been.
It's up in Oregon this year.
Always
a national forest.
I go every year. That's it. And people came up to me throughout and said, "Hey, we listen to the show." And these were people from all over the country that they've heard that this is what we're about. This is what we're making it interesting. And when they come through, Val, you remember the Rainbow guys that would come through to talk about what they're about some years ago, but certainly there they were.
Oh yes, it's definitely an outpost for the Rainbow family to roll through when they do.
Take a look, take a listen. We'll be doing, hey, before I forget, Sunday is what day? It's Jerry Day.
Jerry Day.
Yeah.
I have this tie-dye that was given to me at for the Rainbow Gathering.
Thank you, Jerry.
Yeah, come on over. This
Thank
is going
you,
to
Jerry.
Be.
We love you.
And the whole crew, the Jerry Garcia band plays, and a bunch of really good.
Stu Allen and Mars Hotel, Melvin Seals and JGB.
Okay.
Awesome.
And whose son? Whose son? He's got Past Midnight. He was with the Dead. His son is a band called Past Midnight. That's you got Jerry. Who is the Dead? This guy is still alive. Well, that's his father.
Okay.
We'll remember as we're doing it.
But so anyway, that's going to be over at McLaren Park in the Jerry Garcia Amphitheater.
Oh, my goodness.
And then they're revealing another Jerry Garcia plaque, which was an initiative put forth, it was coming out of City Hall a couple of years ago.
John Avalos.
Jeremy in John Avalos's office. Okay. We're helping with that, and so they're releasing plaques all around San Francisco, because this was his hometown, Jerry Garcia's, and so that's going to be unveiled, and then the concert. Right?
Well, the amphitheater itself was funded by the Rex Foundation, which is their foundation, which they use to do things like big scholarships for kids of color. That's how my daughters first got involved at Camp Winter Rainbow, and many other things, including the Jerry Garcia Amphitheater, which is funded by the Rex Foundation, which is the Grateful Dead proceeds.
Also, we also love the Jerry Garcia mural on Belvedere and Haight Street. And we just finished watching the entire series, Long Strange Trip, which is a new, like, 4 or 5 part series. It's on Amazon Prime, not to plug them or anything, but that's where you go watch it. And it is really, really good. Yeah. It takes you deep into their world. We already loved the boys, but we love Jerry, we love Phil, we love Bobby, just more than ever. Even all of Mickey, Billy, all of them.
Well, Dave probably knows this, but what I walked away with, obviously having Dead in my memory banks and consciousness for my whole life, I didn't realize how foundational they were to the 60s, how much Jerry's philosophies were foundational to what the 60s became. I always thought they were a byproduct. And in the film, it just blew my mind what Jerry was about and how much he helped shape the entire era.
Well, in many perspectives, I was already there when they showed up. I first ran into them, in fact, in 65, I think, at Ken Kesey's place in La Honda.
Ah, yeah.
So we weave all this. I sometimes say, half joking and serious, I'd be 1/3 beatnik because I'm, as I say, 80th birthday. So I turned 30 on that street at the end of the summer, 1967. I was like the old guy then, too. Fuck.
Never trust anyone over 30, but you just.
What happened to never trust anybody over 30, folks? That was very.
They got old if they left.
Yeah, good.
If they made it. Yeah, we want to bring that up too, because we have a segment in our short film soon to be released, An Invitation to Action, and it's broken into 12 segments, and one of those which we care very deeply about is our elders, and we talk about how never trust anyone over 30 was the mentality of the day 50 years ago, and now we are proclaiming in the summer of unconditional love, we wholeheartedly, broad-armed, welcome and embrace all elders, seniors, those who've come before us, those who have seen more than us, and those who deserve our respect, and those from whom we can further thrive as we embrace into our world.
In fact, this brings me back. I remember there was a time in which I was part of Seeds of Peace, the Rainbow Family, and we did the kitchen every year at the test site. And the Navajo Dene people would come up. And the people who lived there, I was on a march with them to the test site, a walk, a stroll, a saunter, with the Havasupi people who live at the bottom of the Grand Canyon. And some years ago, this Rasta guy married into the tribe, and they really took to the Rasta spirit down in the bottom of the bottom of the Grand Canyon, and they were with us at this march. And I remember asking them, well, what is this? This is back in the early 80s. Well, I say, I'm 1/3 beatnik, 1/3 hippie, and 1/3 punk as fuck. And that was the punk rock.
Punk as fuck, right?
Yeah, I was amazed that you knew enough that we could have this conversation. But I asked them,
talk punk anytime.
What is it? I was thinking, an elder. And I said, what is an elder supposed to do? What did I do? I was in my early 60s then, I think. What do you do? And he looked at me, he said, do nothing, just be yourself, that's all.
That's it.
So whatever emerges in your elderness,
sure
is coming out of all your years of experience, is coming out of what we've learned down the road through our mistakes and our successes, and some mistakes that seem like successes, some successes that seem like mistakes. We do all that, but we've emerged. I feel like I've emerged now, soon to be 80 years old, with the beatnik hippie punk as fuck. And we had that conversation when we had, after being tossed out of the academy conference, I sat with you.
Now, we had a great interview with Diamond Dave for our Now Share Love channel.
It was more of an outline. It was more of a monologue with a few questions.
It was an exchange. Come on.
It was an exchange. We did it.
We know that you steamroll the whole thing. We know how to chime in when necessary.
Chime in when necessary. That's how to do it. Chime in when necessary.
Yeah.
These are all the rules of living.
When
we're doing more together than we can do our own, eh, Val?
Absolutely.
And this is what the show is about. And so welcome in, and whatever we can do, we'll be doing more together to advance this cause.
Well, one big thing I want to announce, and let me give you just a tiny bit of history, and there's a wonderful through line that's been going on through the Summer of Love, and it was one of the first three people we met in this whole ordeal, this whole endeavor, this journey, through Adam over at California Historical Society, introduced us to the people who run It's Your District, a nonprofit that helps fuel participation, volunteerism, and community activism, neighborhood by neighborhood, district by district, literally, around San Francisco. And they've been participating in the Sunday Streets events and bringing Summer of Love, 50th anniversary, to Sunday Streets, at which, as I said, we perform back on April 30th for Global Love Day. And the people we were introduced to from that, or the person, was Boots Houston, 2B1 Productions, 2B1 Multimedia, who was vying to put on the free Summer of Love 50th anniversary concert in Golden Gate Park in the Polo Fields.
Right.
And I mean, the original plan involved like the Dalai Lama speaking and just amazing performers and also achieving a 2-day event with a slew of bands, all the heavy hitters, whoever's still alive from the 60s, right? But they got into a battle with Wreckin' Park and ended up getting a permit denied twice. And so we've been following this whole thing. We interviewed Boots in Speedway Meadow, walking into the Polo Field and talking about stage is going to be here, these people are going to play, all this, you know. And it didn't happen. So then we go to City Hall because they filed an appeal and they had a public hearing.
Mm-hmm.
And many people got up and spoke. We covered that whole thing. We were there rooting Boots and everyone on. We've been going to their planning meetings and helping to participate, offering to sponsor, all of it. And just got shot down twice, shot down on appeal twice. And the last person to work with Boots who was going to go ahead and apply, after Sunshine Powers, was going to take a swing at it. She did go have a good meeting with Wreckin' Park, but they just couldn't agree to everything.
Right.
Mona Lisa Wallace,
who wrote
the Woah Manifesto, and we love Mona Lisa. She represents Code Pink and a number of other wonderful organizations. She ended up getting dropped in her lap the most amazing opportunity, a true Summer of Love miracle, as we call it, as we've seen so many so far. We described some earlier. And again, this all came out of the human being back on January 14th, where we first met Val, with Coach Manning to Dave, all of this. And it is the Peace in the Park event in celebration of the UN International Day of Peace, which is on the 21st, but the event is on Saturday, September 23rd. S.O.U.L. will be co-producing, co-curating the programming. We're going to take the best of people we've discovered throughout this whole year. I just ran into Greg Castillo, who co-curated the Hippie Modernism exhibition at the Berkeley Art Museum this year.
Goodness.
I just ran into him a block away on my way in here tonight. I said, we want you to speak, to represent Latino community, to represent Hippie Modernism. They worked for 10 years building that exhibition. These people have studied the counterculture and recognize the relevance today, and they're awesome at articulating it. We've got it on our channel, on our videos, of our interviews with him, but we're going to get him to speak, and all of our favorite people that we've met this year, we're going to invite to come up and present at Peace in the Park on September 23rd. It's in the Music Concourse right outside the Young Museum in California Academy of Sciences in Golden Gate Park, and that's an all-day event, 11 to 6, free event. S.O.U.L. Twin Messiah will be performing all original new music. We played you one of the songs acoustically here in the studio today, and we're developing those songs right now for an electric extended jam versions in the band shell. So stay tuned for a lot of cool speakers and bands, music, and everything to be announced. It's a cool, chill festival brought to, it's the fifth annual. Brahma Kumaris have put it on. It's a really chill group. They do meditations, yoga. There are speaker tents, activities for children. It's going to be a cool event. So mark the calendar September 23rd for Golden Gate Park. We're super stoked to be, you know,
well, I think we're already counted in.
And if I could, we want to see Dave there.
Before I forget, since you both talked a little bit and brought up Great Concealing History, and you guys were both talking about punk, at this conference we were just at, they did a thing on the hippies and punk and, you know, the punks hating the hippies and filmy film, blah, blah, blah. But they showed a clip of Jerry, and I just really want to share this, is that he said something that I think was so dead on. Everybody came here looking for that whatever was happening here. Well, whatever had happened, that pebble dropped in the water that set off the ripple effect, had already started. And he said by the time people came, that ripple had already spread out. Now we see that ripple going all the way around the world, and people are in every country, they've taken and not tried to copy it, but make it their own.
That's right.
You know, in every country around the world. So again, we have succeeded beyond our wildest dreams in many ways.
And here we are.
Yeah.
They heard it around the world. And what do you say, history? I say hipstery. I say hipstery because it's just occasionally that a camera like this, they kind of see something's happening and talk about it, but we're talking about these real underground connections that we talked about, mm-hmm. that we continue to talk about. And I'm glad that Mona Lisa's doing that. I know that what Mona Lisa does, we're part of it as well. She'll be here at the appropriate time to let us know if she comes in regularly. And I did a whole series for years. I did something at the band show called Food Not Bombs. We fed people every year. Well, it was called Soup Stock. The minute I got old, what was it? Soup Stock.
That's right.
We fed people. You were there.
I'm going to put in a nomination for Diamond Dave here officially. A nomination. We'll see how it goes. But we're doing a peace award ceremony where we're going to acknowledge people who have put on events to promote peace, love, et cetera, especially in the park. It's really for people in the park. So sounds like you pretty much qualify there. So
yeah,
put that out there. It's us and Mona Lisa now.
It was called Hipstery. And every year we do it with the bands of the time. There were sales with a lot of semi-punk and semi-punk through those years. This was the 80s and 90s. And we set up and cooked there. All of this was also it was up to the Rainbow Gathering, and I talked to people around. I think we're talking to people on the 50th anniversary. And of course, the Rainbow Gathering. It used to be out there, and they said, "Where's your permit?" We said, "We have a permit. It's called the First Amendment of the Constitution. We have a permit. It's our natural First Amendment of the Constitution that guarantees our right to speak freely. Well, we're doing this now under the radar for sure, but we're speaking freely here. Is that right?"
Yeah.
You don't have to pull any punches here, ho, ho, ho.
Fuck
punches
yeah.
Punches, yeah. Thank you for the fuck yeah.
Right.
And hipstery,
we got our station kicked off of AM radio for saying that, by the way.
Okay,
we are extremely proud.
Well, we're on the underground now. You're welcome here. You're going to be hard to get us kicked off because we're under the radar.
We're just on the internet. We're not the regulated FCC station.
But I can hear it on my handheld device, which I'm having. So our First Amendment the right to speak freely, to whatever be our spiritual path. Mm-hmm. I follow Rumi and said there are hundreds of ways.
Wow, I love Rumi.
Hundreds of ways to kneel and kiss the ground. They even say I'm Sufi.
Yeah.
That's Rumi and Hafiz. And that whatever be our spiritual path, and then we've got to gather, to assemble. And so I told people when they're coming down, and maybe there'll be a few teepees set up, and we'll feed the people. There's a lot of leftover, and we'll feed the people. Any event we have, we also feed the people.
Diamond Dave, the whirling dervish.
We love it. We're going to have to bring out some food at the
body,
park.
Mind, and spirit.
We did, when on Global Love Day on the Tenderloin, we brought out these massive med platters. They delivered them from La Mediterranea. We had like five platters and the lina. And for like 40 minutes, people were plating up food. We doled out so many dolmas and slapped so much hummus and baba ganoush. It was so much fun.
We're going to have to do a little food.
Free food frenzy at Peace in the Park.
And
Resurrection of Food Not Bombs. We serve every Thursday, cook and serve every Thursday. But that's pretty much it. And back in the day, any event, we'd be there serving. Why don't you do one more song? Then we got Mike from Benning, who's come with his songs. So it's good, baby.
You got me.
Big good, huh?
All right.
Perfect. Why not?
Okay.
Imagine.
Okay, well, imagine.
Coco?
I wonder if you can.
I wonder.
Guys, I know
thank
this
you
is
so
a
much.
We love you.
Thank you
so
let's continue.